Hi and welcome back. In the previous lesson, you've learned how to configure and run Katalon Studio tests with different browsers, versions, and OS. Now, I will show you how to schedule test runs with TestCloud in TestOps. First, let's log into Katalon TestOps. Navigate to testop.katalon.io. Then, enter your Katalon account credentials. This is what my current organization looks like. You can create a new organization by clicking on the drop-down icon in the menu, select Create New Organization, and follow the instructions. In case you are new to Katalon TestOps, it's a platform where you can centralize and orchestrate all testing activities, from test management, planning, execution, integration, to reporting. Alright, to schedule test runs with TestCloud, click on Test Execution. This big test run calendar shows you all the historical test runs, their execution dates, and the result. Continue to select the Schedule Test Run button in the right corner. Then, you will need to answer three questions. The what, where, and when. Let's walk through each section quickly. First, give this test run a name. Then, choose the script repository where your test suites or test suite collections are stored. If you don't have an existing repository in TestOps, you can create a new one by clicking on Create a New One here. It will drag you to the configuration page where you can easily create a script repository in TestOps. From here, select Create Git Script Repository. Choose GitHub or any other source type. Paste in the URL to your Git repository. Then, fill in your username and personal access token. You can create this by searching and following the guidelines from your specific source code repository. Then, click on Connect. Go back to the Schedule Test Run section. After giving it a name, choose your script repository, then continue to pick what you want to run, test suite or test suite collection. You can also use Katalon or a generic command to pick the test you want to run. I'll go for a test suite, then choose to run it on Chrome headless. Next, in the Where to Run section, choose TestCloud Test Environment for type. Then, in the TestCloud section below, specify the environment you want. I'll go for Linux, Chrome, and version 97. I also want to run the test suite with Windows Chrome version 99. Just a quick note, make sure that you turn off the copy-down integration in the advanced settings. At the moment, TestCloud supports web application environments in certain operating systems, Linux and Windows. By the time you watch this course, more options will have been added. Make sure to check them out. Finally, you'll need to set up the where to run. You can trigger the test runs and have them repeated after a certain interval in a time frame. But I want to run this test suite now. To do so, click on the Repeat toggle to turn off the scheduling function. You can see the Schedule button in the bottom right has been turned into Run. Select it. It will redirect me to the Test Run List tab. Looking at our test, in the first line, you can see the name, the location, the test environment. There are two in this case, one with Linux and the other one with Windows. The days of the last and the next run, if any. On the right is the little run button that will trigger the test run immediately. You can further click on the name to see all the historical data. From here, you have the option to run, edit, or delete it. Let's switch to the report category to see how our tests are running. Continue to select the Test Runs tab and scroll down to the All Test Runs section. You may not see all the details right now since our tests are still up and running. Continue to click on the ID to view more details of this test run. Scrolling down, you can see the test suite runs two times. The first one with Linux is complete. The second one with Windows is still running. Let's wait a bit until they are complete. Alright, they are both passed. Further click on the ID of each test suite if you want to see the detailed test logs. If you go back to the old test run section, the results have been fully updated. From the left to the right, the execution status is passed. The ID, the name of the test run and the selected test suite, the platforms or environments used to run the test, the running time, the pass-fail results of this test run. There were two tests in total. This suite ran two times with two predefined environments, meaning each suite had one test case. All the tests passed. And that is what I want to show you in this chapter, scheduling and running tests in TestOps with TestCloud environments. You can now log into TestOps, try it out, and explore other features. In the next chapter, we'll show you how to use TestCloud Tunnel to run tests and why should you do so. Stay tuned. Bye.